Hey everybody and welcome back to Calm Your Dog. Now for today's video, I'm going to be talking to you guys about how to introduce a dog to a cat. Now if you guys have already got a cat and you really want to get a dog, this video will be perfect for you just to get a little bit of understanding as to what you need to do to prepare for that transaction that is about to happen. Now just for a little bit of background and a bit of reference for you guys, I had my cat Rio. He was about just less than 2 years old when we introduced Milo, which is my dog, my border collie. As you know, border collies are extremely excitable dogs, and my cat is a very, very calm cat. So we obviously knew that before we even introduced them to each other, there needed to be a few things, a few boundaries that needed to be put in place, which I'll talk to you guys a little bit more throughout this video. But before we do get started, please do let us know down below in the comments. What do you guys think? Have you got a cat? Do you want to introduce a dog? Please let us know. Or have you done this before and you've got a bit of tips and tricks to share with everybody? Please do let us know down below in the comments, and you might actually get a shout out in next week's video, so make sure you are doing that. But let's just get started. So obviously, when you're introducing a dog to a cat, there are lots and lots of different options that you can do to help this transaction between them meeting be a lot easier. So the first method, and obviously one of the most important, is to keep them separate at first. Obviously the first thing you want to do is introduce them to each other, but dogs and cats have that stereotypical thing that they just don't like each other and they don't get on, and this can definitely still be the case with some dogs and cats, so you need to be wary of that. You also don't want the cat to attack the dog or the dog to override the cat or anything like that, so you need to make sure you're keeping them separate at first. Obviously, if them being in close proximities to each other anyway, they'll be able to get a bit of the scent, they'll be able to learn a bit more about the animal, but you don't want to introduce them straight away to each other. The next one is to feed them on opposite sides of a closed door. This is a great way for them to get the scent. If you've got one with glass as well, this might be a good idea. The scent, they'll be able to potentially see the other animal, and they'll be able to do something that dogs and cats find quite vulnerable, like eating is quite a vulnerable thing for them to do. They're in a bit of a vulnerable state, so them being able to eat next to each other is kind of them dropping a few barriers already, just by doing something simple like that. Now the next one, of course, if you are introducing a dog to a cat, you need to make sure that the dog knows some basic commands. Obviously you put in a puppy that isn't trained, doesn't know anything at all about anything at that point, and putting them in front of a cat can be quite overwhelming for both the cat and the dog, because the dog will obviously just see it as a friend and the cat will be like, I need to not be near this animal right now. So making sure that your dog is available to or knows basic commands like sit, stay, that sort of thing, just the generic ones, can really, really help fasten this process a little bit more. And the next one is to start introducing face-to-face meetings. Now this should be quite short. You should have a few people in the room, at least two people who are able to sort of grab the dog and one can grab the cat and that sort of thing, and just let the cat have their own space, let the dog have their own space. Obviously they'll want to see each other, they'll want to potentially interact with each other, but don't let it be too over the top, because you don't want to overface either animal and make them get scared and frightened and potentially attack the other one. Obviously the cat can jump a lot higher, so they should have an area where they can get up where the dog isn't able to get access to them. And again, you should just be repeating this sort of daily. As soon as they start getting comfortable with each other, that's when you can relax as an owner a little bit more. But that is it for this week's video. Thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Of course, don't forget to comment down below. And also don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Now, our shout out from last week's video goes to a Barbara. Hi, Barbara. She says, I love it when dogs chase their tails. My cat chases his tail too. It's so adorable. I've never seen my cat chase his tail. He probably has done, I just haven't caught him doing it. But when Milo used to chase his tail, it honestly just used to make everybody laugh, because it's like a child, you know, when you egg a child on because you're laughing at them. That's what I felt like it was like with Milo, and he'd love it, he'd love to get all the attention. So yes, thank you so much for your comment, and don't forget to comment in today's video to potentially get a shout out in my next video. But that is it, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all then, bye.